that you may dwell, that for He is your life. He is our life. He is the life that is on the inside of us. He is the life of our spirit man. He is the life of our intellect. He's the life in your memory, in your brain. He is the life in your eyesight. He is life. Yes. He is life. Yes. Praise God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, praise God. Life, words, the words of life. You choose. Now, what does that say to you? Well, I'll tell you what it says to me. He's already made His choice. He said, I set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. You choose. He has already chosen you. He has already chosen me. All you have to be for God to choose you is breathing. Now, after you step out of that body, it's a whole new thing. This physical body is our authority in the earth. Human beings have authority in this earth, whether they know it or not, whether they ever do anything about it or not. You can go to hell if you want to. Now, John said, there is a sin unto death, and I do not ask that you pray for that or for him. There is a sin unto death. Now, I'll cut that short for you. This is a person born again, and it's all right there in the book of Hebrews, born again, filled with the Spirit, operating in the gifts of the Spirit, and has made the decision to trample underfoot the blood that sanctified it. It's not that God will not forgive him or her. The book just says it is impossible to bring them to repentance. They know what the book says. They can quote parts of it to you. Oh my.